is a short story written by Indian writer Kushwant Singh. It was published in 1989 in the collected stories. Kushwant Singh was also a lawyer, diplomat, journalist and politician. In 2007, he was awarded Padma Vibhushan, the second highest civilian award in India. Watch this video to know the character, outline summary, round versus flat characters, setting, narrator's point of view, style, themes, and moral of this short story, Karma. The characters involved in this short story are Sir Mohan Lal, an arrogant middle-aged Indian, Lady Mohan Lal, whose name is Lakshmi, wife of Sir Mohan Lal, a bearer, a porter, or a coolie. Bill and Jim are the British soldiers. Now, let us move to the outline summary of this short story, Karma. Scene 1. Waiting room in Indian Railway Station. Sir Mohan Lal is a middle-aged Indian who works in the British Raj. Mohan Lal is ashamed to be an Indian and hence he tries to speak in English and dresses up as a high-ranked British official. In those days, the first-class compartment in the train is only meant for the British people, and Indian-born Mohan Lal usually travels in first-class compartment as if he considers himself as British. Mohan Lal always feels inferior being an Indian. Hence, Mohan Lal endeavors to change himself completely in favoring the habits and mannerism of Englishmen. When this short story begins, Sir Mohan Lal, the protagonist, looks at himself in the mirror. He smiles at the mirror in the waiting room and says to the person appearing in the mirror, that is, he talks to himself in the mirror, that he is very dirty like everyone in the country. The mirror smiles at him back and says that he was a distinguished person. His dressing makes him look even more smart and handsome. Later, Mohan Lal goes out from the waiting room and asks a bearer to give him a small pig. Scene 2. Outside the waiting room at Indian Railway Station. The important event occurs on a journey of Mohan Lal and his wife Lakshmi in a train. Mohan Lal makes his wife Lakshmi sit in the Zenana compartment. Zenana compartment is known to be the ladies' compartment. While Mohan Lal, he himself gets his seat arranged in the first class compartment, which is specially meant for the British. Because Mohan Lal considers his wife submissive to him. Lakshmi is a traditional Indian woman and poor illiterate. Due to this difference, Mohan Lal and Lakshmi do not lead a sweet married life. They even don't have children. Now Lakshmi is sitting at the waiting room outside and chewing betel leaves. She wears a dirty white sari with red border and she has several gold bangles in her arms. She asks the coolie where the Zenana would stop, to which the coolie replies that the Zenana compartment would stop at the end of the platform. As they hear the signal and the bell sound, which symbolizes that the train is approaching. Therefore, the coolie picked up the luggage of Lakshmi and by following the coolie, Lakshmi walks to the end of the platform. In order to get seat, in Zenana compartment. They both reached the end of the platform. Meanwhile, Lakshmi opened her brass lunch box and eats her meal, chapatis and some mango pickles. Then there happens a very active conversation between Lakshmi and the coolie. Lakshmi is very fond of talking if she gets a chance, because Lakshmi had nobody to talk to her in the house. Her husband, Sir Mohanlal, was always busy with his clients and he would never have time to speak to his wife, Lakshmi. Scene 3. When there are signals of the train arriving, Lakshmi washed her hands and proceeded towards the Zenana compartment. She gives 2 annas to the coolie for carrying her luggage and she immediately dismissed the coolie. After taking a seat in the Zenana compartment, Lakshmi opens the box of betel leaves and put 2 in her mouth. Gradually, her mouth and cheeks bulge. Scene 4. On the other side of the platform, Lakshmi's husband is waiting to get seat in the first class compartment. The arrival of the train do not make a difference to Sir Mohanlal. He made the coolie takes his luggage to the first class compartment. Mohanlal had stayed 5 years in abroad and had acquired the features of the upper class people. Mohanlal always used to speak necessary words only in English. When Mohanlal sits in first class compartment, he is aware that some Englishmen are traveling in the train. He is not very keen to talk to them. Mohanlal takes a copy of the Times newspaper and solved a crossword in it, because Mohanlal believes that newspaper always attracts the attention of people. He would never go out anywhere unless he had a copy of the Times newspaper and his tie with him. So Mohanlal's thoughts are disturbed. He looked out of the window at the crowded platform from the train. He sees 2 Englishmen named Bill and Jim approaching him, and so he gets excited. Sir Mohanlal knows very well that he is supposed to sit in a second class compartment as he is born as an Indian. One of the soldier comes to see him and showed Sir Mohanlal to the other soldier and asked him to get out from the first class compartment immediately. Both the British soldiers, Bill and Jim, come and picks up Sir Mohanlal's luggage, and not listening to his protest, the British soldiers pushed him out from the first class compartment. Meanwhile, the engine whistled and the soldiers ignored the feeble protest of Sir Mohanlal. Gradually, Sir Mohanlal lost his speech and sees the train passing by standing on the platform helplessly. Whereas in the Zenana compartment, Lakshmi is sitting with her mouth filled with betel leaves. As the train whistles and leaves the platform, Mohanlal's wife, Lakshmi, is spitting the betel leaf as soon as the train departs from the railway station. At the end of the story, Sir Mohanlal is humiliated by 2 British soldiers, Bill and Jim, whom he considers to be his fellow traveler. While his wife, Lakshmi, on the other side, makes a peaceful journey in her inter-class Zenana compartment. However, Sir Mohanlal gets his punishment for his fake pride in British culture and manners. On the other hand, his wife, Lakshmi enjoys a peaceful journey. Just as Mohanlal considers himself better than his wife Lakshmi, many English people consider themselves better than Indians. Finally, Mohanlal gets what he deserves. So, that's the title Karma signifies in the short story. In this short story, Sir Mohanlal, his wife Lakshmi, two British soldiers, Bill and Jim, are all flat characters who remain the same throughout the story. And there is no round character in this short story. Next, the setting took place in Indian Railway Station. This short story is narrated in third person point of view by an unnamed narrator, and the author used simple language and no complex words. You can read this story in one sitting with only one main plot with limited number of characters and no subplots. And the possible themes that involved in this short story are Indian and foreign culture, society, prejudice, fear, lifestyle, aristocracy, married life, patriotism, identity, shame, insecurity, heritage, humanity, self-importance, discrimination, arrogance, ignorance, male domination. In this short story, Kushwant Singh is suggesting that an individual should be proud of who they are and should not adopt another country's behaviors and habits as their own. Otherwise, an individual would face karma just like Sir Mohanlal in this short story, Karma. Thank you.